All right, so Newton's first law is the law of inertia. Which states that the property of an object that resists changes in motion. So what this means is that an object at rest will remain at rest unless it is acted upon by a force. So for example, if I were to be kicking a soccer ball, actually let's backtrack a little bit. If the soccer ball is just on the ground, that is, it's just constant there, it's not moving at all because there has not been a force applied to it. But if I was a soccer player that was coming up to kick the ball, then I would apply a force to the soccer ball, therefore it would be in constant motion. That is a law of inertia.
Today we're going to learn about Newton's second law, and that states that the acceleration of an object as produced by a net force is directly proportional to the magnitude of the net force in the same direction as the net force and inversely proportional to the mass of the object. So, I'm going to show you this force equation. States that force equals mass times acceleration. So if you're trying to become like Usain Bolt and run a 9.58 in the 100, you need to increase your acceleration and decrease your mass. So for this acceleration equation, this will equal acceleration equals force divided by mass. So, if you can increase your force and decrease your mass, you will maximize your acceleration. So, a good example of this is like using starting blocks. The reason why sprinters use starting blocks when they run is to maximize their acceleration. And acceleration at the start is very important in sprint races because of the short duration of the race. So, to increase this, so I'm gonna give you an example of starting blocks, but sadly we didn't have any starting blocks. They're like $600 too. I ain't got that kind of cash on me. So I'm gonna use this wall instead. It'll be similar to a swimmer, like swimming when you propel off the wall. Same concept. So make sure you get some stretching for sure. Don't want to pull any muscles. So my back foot will be producing the most force because I'll be using that to push off the blocks, just like Usain Bolt, go for speed. All right, so as stated earlier, a heavier object with a greater mass is gonna take more force to accelerate. And so one way to help you get a visual representation of what you're movement will look like is doing free body diagrams. So I'm gonna draw one for you. All right, here's my stick figure. It's pretty great, I'd like to say. And so these will allow you show you where all the forces are going. So, you got some ground reaction forces, like feet. Got some air resistance because you be going, you trying to go this way. So, if you're going this way, you're gonna have some resistance this way, like this. And the length of this line, this arrow, which is a vector, which allows you to put these into x and y coordinates.
So the law of interaction states that for every action, there's an equal or opposite reaction. So what that means is that, for example, right here against the wall, so when I apply a force to this wall, that force that I'm applying to the wall is directly going to be transmitted back to me. For an example, for runners, is when you take off the starting block, also all the force from the push leg that is being applied to the ground or to the block is reversely applied back into the leg, which makes it go forward process. If we think about it without any gravity, if we were in space and we had a wall and we went up and pushed against the wall and myself would go in opposite directions at the same speed and the same acceleration.